So we are going to discuss about ureter. So first let us draw the kidney. So on which side you will have the hilum, that will be the medial side, and which side you don't have the hilum, that will be the lateral side. So from the medium side at the hilum here, actually you'll have the renal pelvis. So from the renal pelvis the ureter begins, and it is connecting the kidney to the urinary bladder below. Okay, so this is a ureter. Actually there are a pair of ureters, like each for one kidney, right? They are narrow, they are thick walled, and they are muscular tubes and mainly made up of smooth muscle. Okay, they are muscular tubes made up of smooth muscles. They convey the urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. Okay, and one more thing is that they lie deep to the peritoneum, means they are like deep to the peritoneum, and they are closely applied to posterior abdominal wall. So they are in posterior abdominal wall. Okay, and in the upper part they are in posterior abdominal wall. Okay, and lateral and to the lateral pelvic wall in lower part. So in the lower part they are in lateral pelvic wall. Okay, so ureter is divided into abdominal part and pelvic part. So now coming to the course, we already discussed it is passing downwards, and it passes slightly medially on the psoas major muscle. Okay, it passes on psoas major muscle, that too medially. Okay, and it is crossing in front of termination of common iliac artery. So actually here you will have aorta, and it will divide into, you know, common iliac artery. So where it divides into common iliac artery, at that place our ureter enters the pelvis. Okay, and next coming to the anterior margin, it also follows the anterior margin of greater sciatic notch and reach to the base of urinary bladder. So now coming to the constrictions. So mainly ureter is slightly constricted in three places. The first place is pelvico-uteric junction. So this is called as pelvi-uretric junction. So here you'll have the first constriction. So first constriction is in pelvico-uretric junction, that is between the pelvis and ureter. Okay, and the second one is at the brim of lesser pelvis. So somewhere over here you'll be having a brim of lesser pelvis. So here you'll be having the second constriction. And the third constriction is at the passage through bladder wall. So here, so at the bladder wall, here you are having a third constriction. So total three constrictions. Now let us discuss about abdominal part of pelvis. So this is abdominal part of ureter. Abdominal part of ureter. So let us discuss about this part. Okay. So the abdominal part of ureter, anteriorly if you observe, will be having the third part of duodenum here. Okay, so first one is third part of duodenum. You know duodenum is divided into three parts. So the third part of duodenum is near to the abdominal part of ureter, anteriorly. Okay, and next you'll be having the peritoneum. Okay, next you'll be having peritoneum anteriorly. Of course I discussed already, kidney is a retroperitoneal organ, so even then ureter also will be retroperitoneal because it's related to it. So it will be covered by peritoneum only on anterior side but not on the posterior side. Okay, so anteriorly, that's why you're having third part of duodenum, you're having peritoneum, and next you'll be having right colic vessels. Here you'll be having a right colic artery and a right colic vein. Okay, so these are the right colic vessels. And next you'll be having ileocolic vessels. So same like this colic vessel, right colic vessels, you'll be also having ileocolic vessels. And after that you'll be also having gonadal vessels. Okay, and also you'll be having a root of mesentery. So you know the root of mesentery, like this it will be. Okay, so root of mesentery. And Next, you will be also having the sigmoid colon. Wait, root of mesentery and terminal part of ilium. Terminal part of ilium. So these are all the relations, anterior relations of abdominal part of aorta on right side. So let me show this original diagram. So here you can see this is the abdominal part of right side of ureter. So here you can see first one what we discussed, third part of duodenum. Next you will be having peritoneum, it is not shown here. Next you will be having right colic vessels, okay, and also you will be having ileocolic vessels, okay, and you will be also having gonadal vessels, and you will be having a root of mesentery and also the terminal part of ileum. So everything is shown here, okay. Now directly let us discuss by means of this diagram the left side relations of ureter. So on the left side, if you see, mainly you will be having a peritoneum, okay, and also you will be having a gonadal artery, left gonadal artery, and also you will be having the left colic vessels, clearly you can see here, and also there is sigmoid colon, root of sigmoid mesocolon, means this is a sigmoid colon, and next the sigmoid mesocolon. So these are all the structures which are related on the left side of abdominal part of of ureter. And next coming to posterior relations. So posterior relations, for that let us draw a diagram. So for example, this is a ureter, okay, so this is anterior side, okay, then this is posterior side. On posterior side you'll be having one muscle, and that is a psoas major muscle, okay, and also you'll be having a tips of transverse process of colon, okay, transverse process, and also there will be a genitofemoral nerve. So these are the posterior relations of ureter. And next coming to the medial side. So let me show this diagram. So you can see on the medial side you will be actually also having a inferior vena cava, and on the right side, so this diagram. So here on the right side you will be having inferior vena cava like this, okay, and on the left side you will be having a left gonadal vein, okay, left gonadal vein, this one, and also you'll be having further medially inferior mesenteric vein, this one, okay. So on the left side you'll be having a gonadal vein and inferior mesenteric vein, on the right side you're having inferior vena cava, okay. So by means of this diagram, let us understand now the pelvic part of ureter. So we already discussed this is the abdominal part of ureter. Now let us see the relations of pelvic part of ureter. So posterior to the pelvic part of ureter, you will be finding an internal iliac artery. So here you can clearly see the external iliac vessels, and these are the internal iliac vessels, okay. So there will be an internal iliac artery. So in this diagram you can see clearly this is the internal iliac artery, and also there is commencement of anterior trunk of internal iliac artery, and also there is internal iliac vein. So for that you can see here this is internal iliac vessels, okay, and also posteriorly there is a lumbosacral trunk. This one represents the lumbosacral trunk here, and also there is sacroiliac joint. So sacroiliac joint is nothing but between the sacrum and our hip bone.